back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, to Let's Roleplay Fallout New Vegas. In the last one, we helped get Springs repel the Powder Gangers and became sort of a town hero to the people of Good Springs. Now we find ourselves in Primm, where the entire town has been locked down due to raider, convict activity. These aren't Powder Gangers anymore. They're a splinter group. So Sam has decided the best thing that he can do is to sneak into the town, do what the NCR can't, and check on the people, because he still has goals that he needs to do. Hey.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on that.
Yeah, but what are you gonna do about these convicts?
Got business here?
Yeah. We're going to, see if we can't open a way for your forces here to help out the town.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Yeah. I get it. He can't really acknowledge what I'm saying. Alright. Easy does it. If this goes bad, we could destroy the entire overpass. Oh, I'm over encumbered. Alright. So the plan is, to go wide. Check out these shacks. It's 10:21, so there shouldn't be too many people out. Nobody. Okay. Some Nuka-Cola bottles, a pair of crutches, some entire engine block, harmonica, and some stew. Stop and eating. Chessboard. Gun case. A silenced pistol. It's not really our thing, but if the opportunity arises. Okay, no one behind the building. Oh, there's one. Let's just try to see if we can take stock. Gatherings. A desk. Terminal. She's just lend a hand for Uncle Sam. Enlist today. is that? A cowboy repeater. Versus 13 damage. Okay. Ooh. Okay. Doesn't seem to be any more out here. Okay. 7-5 is this. $5, 9mm, fixer, temporary addiction removal. Oh wow, did I manage to bag his head? Squirrel stew. Daniel Wind. Mojave Express delivery order 4 of 6. Deliver the package at the north entrance to the Vegas Strip by way of Freeside. An agent of the recipient will meet you at the checkpoint and take possession of the package and pay for the delivery. Bring the payment to Johnson Nash. 2 oversized dice composed of a fuzzy material. That is the same deal. Huh. Interesting. Well, here's the Mojave Express. So,
do
What's up, Johnson Nash? Is oh no.
But you shouldn't, because it's a sin to tell a lie.
Well, that's weird. Who would have been gathering a report on me? It's a damaged robot. Okay. My child is an honor student at Roosevelt Academy. This is an advanced model robot with a reinforced frame. It is well weathered and appears to have seen a good bit of action. There is very little in the way of serious damage. Okay, well, let's try to fix it. Some servos and gyroscopes need to be recalibrated and replaced, but it looks as though the robot can be repaired. Okay, 65 or higher. That's not me. What about parts? It looks as though the damaged servos and gyroscopes could be replaced with the correct components. 3 pieces of scrap metal, 2 sensor modules, and some scrap electronics. Okay. What do we have? We have scrap electronics, scrap metal, sensor modules. Hey! We just need this. Well, we don't know. Well, if they're dead, they won't mind. And if they're not dead, maybe they'll reward me. Okay. Oh. Eddie. EDE. Eddie. Yeah. Companion protocol begin. Eddie is giving you the enhanced senses perk. Okay. Wow. Oh, look at that. Eddie, 59, Great Midwest, Illinois. Okay. Let's see, you've got an integrated reloading bench and a workbench. Some storage. Let's see if you can help me make some ammo. We'll break down the long rifle. Let's make a 9mm round. Okay. Let's break down some of the 308 rounds. Alright. The Bison Steve. Or the Vickian Vance. Hey, isn't this... Well, no, you weren't with me. This has got the death card, doesn't it? Let's take a look.
I don't know what it was brought you to Primm, youngster, but you might want to rethink your plans. Town's gone to hell.
Who are you?
Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Primm going on 8 years now, thick and thin. I'm a trader primarily, for what it's worth with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
Mr. Nash, I'm a courier with the Mojave Express.
Well, I don't got any work right now, sorry to say.
Well, I lost a package I was supposed to deliver.
I'll do whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me?
Yeah, what can you tell me?
Oh, you're talking about one of them packages. That job had Strange written all over, but we couldn't turn down the cash.
Well, what was so strange about it?
That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers. Each was carrying something a little different. A pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I have in the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in.
He canceled?
Yeah, I got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real. I said, sure as lack of rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job, just like that. I asked if he was sure it was good money. No, but Courier 6 carried the package. That's what he said. Like the Mojave sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out.
Well, do you know who he was? Where he went?
No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that. And turn down the money, too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name was bad luck. Enough for me to say.
Well, some men stole my package. A man in a checkered suit and some thugs. Did they pass this way?
Well, now that you mentioned it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them great con misfits. They was talking about a chip.
One. Oh, excuse me. One of those men shot me. I need to know the best way to get to them.
Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Bigan. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on them, and he was slinking around Bison Steve when your pretty boy friend came through. He may have heard where they were going.
Well, I'd like to ask you about something else.
I guess I don't have anywhere better to be.
What can I do to help Primm?
Right now, Beagle's the closest Prim's got to any organized law. But he's still stuck up in Bison Steve. First thing I'd say is get his sorry butt out of there.
Okay. Well, do you have anything for sale?
Sure, have a look.
You, my friend, can have that. Surplus, that's fine. All right. I'll pay with this, and NCR bucks if I can. Will you not take it? There we go. Man, NCR cash isn't worth anything. Alright. Thank you.
Bye.
Alright, Eddie. Let's see if we can't get, get Deputy to be a lot of the situation he finds himself in. Oh! That's not good. More money. Let's see here. Tales of a Jerky Town Vendor. Woo! There we go. Awful dark in here. What was that I picked up? Tales of a Junktown Jerky Vendor. Barter increased by 3. Well, that'll help, I suppose. Rifle. Doing all right. Okay. I wouldn't mind trying to sell that. And I got some replacement for my leather armor. Good deal. Must be Deputy Beagle.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me. I'd cross my fingers, but my hands are numb.
Yeah. Well, You must be the deputy.
Why, yes, I am. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm in a bit of a predicament here. I'd be most appreciative if you'd set me free.
Well, I hear you may have information on some cons that came through here with a guy in a checkered suit. Go ahead and tell me about
Indeed
that.
Indeed, I do, good sir. And I will be thrilled to share that information with you as soon as I am released from captivity.
Yeah, I'll set you free now.
Oh, that's just marvelous. I think I'll be making my way outside now. The air is a little close in here.
Like, I cut you loose just so you can run away? Like, I don't want your help?
I know, it's incredibly generous and altruistic of you. See you outside.
Lawman. Come on, Eddie. Let's make sure none of these convicts can make a counterattack. Then we'll meet him outside. Oh!
You like
that? How do you like that? Let's just drink some sarsaparilla just in case. Oh! Oh, Eddie, I'm so sorry. Oh. Are you okay? Ah, jeez. That's not really my kind of hat. And neither is that, but it's better than the Desperado. More money. Okay. Let's see here. Some soda. Goes outside. Oh. Mr. Peterson, if you want to see your wife alive again, bring the cash and small unmarked bills to the Bison team on Tuesday. Someone didn't respect it. The ransom. That's for sure. There we go. Oh. Someone wanted to go out with a bang then, didn't they? A drug deal, maybe? Pre-war. Now, there was a passage up to the second floor. I think it might have been in... Yeah, here. Cigarettes, suitcases, a weapon case, armor case, metal armor, combat knife. Yeah, we'll be having that. Is this? That's a knife. Some pork and beans. Yeah, that helps. Where did this guy go? This key is significant. Hopefully it'll unlock this gun cabinet. Ooh, a caravan shotgun. 20 gauge. We'll be taking that. And we can leave behind sell our single shotgun. That worked out. Now let's make sure that there's nothing through here. Through this door. And then we can probably return to the Bison Steve. Feels like we've been in here all night. That we'll go ahead and head down. There we go. Okay. The Mickey and Vans Casino.
Howdy. Thanks for freeing the deputy. A bit, anyway.
A bit. Hey, Beagle.
Well, that was quite an adventure. We taught those convicts a thing or two, didn't we? Breaking myself out of a hostage situation. Not to diminish your role in it, of course, but it was quite thrilling. Problem is, there's still no law in Primm. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage?
What are you talking about? Deputy just got a promotion. You're the sheriff now, Beagle.
Oh, no. I'm just a deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command.
Oh, yeah. Well, what are the qualifications for being a sheriff, then, Beagle?
It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the Powder Gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already.
Yeah. What are you doing in here? You could patrol.
Well, a deputy isn't much good without a sheriff. So I figured I'd come in here and protect these good people until someone finds us a new one.
Yeah, all right, goodbye.
Maybe next time you can bring a new sheriff back with you.
Yeah, you know, I think I will. But you know... You owe me.
A suitable candidate for our next sheriff?
Yeah, sure. But you're going to tell me about the man in the checkered suit first.
Yes. My memory is much clearer now that I'm free from my bondage. I was performing recon, gathering information on some of the Powder Gangers, when some great cons arrived with your friend in the suit. They were talking about some delivery they took from a courier. I assume that was you. They said
yeah.
They'd be heading through Nipton to Novak to meet a contact there.
Thanks, Beagle. We could head straight there. This town, though. It needs the NCR's help. Maybe Lieutenant Hayes will know what to do. Sergeant, let's just heading in here. It's in a haze.
Yeah.
I'm sure that you've noticed, but Primm is in dire need of some real law. And the NCR could use a town actually dedicated to the NCR in the Mojave.
We know Primm is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
What do you need to take over protecting the town?
What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff and still handle our primary objective of protecting the interstate south of here. If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Primm and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help.
Okay. Knight. Gotcha. Sure. Mojave Outpost. Now, if I remember right, Mojave Outpost is technically the way back home to California. Okay. Well, that's just what we'll do. Come on, Eddie. Time to become lawbringers. And maybe.
When I got this assignment, I was hoping there'd be more gambling.
Maybe get a little bit closer to New Vegas then. Okay. So. We need to head south along the highway. And then head west. All right. Well, we've got the light, so it shouldn't be too hard. And with those sensors of yours, we'll know trouble's coming long before I can even see it. California Sunset Drive-In. Yeah. What are you doing? Oh my gosh. Caravan shotgun. Eddie, we gotta be more careful. That could end very badly for us. Magnum. Yeah, we'll go with the Magnum. Just to make sure. to make some ammo. It's a trooper. A service rifle. Hello. Oh. Oh, yes. Eddie, why don't you hold on to some of my spares, right? Thanks, buddy. I wonder if there's anything on the radio.
Welcome back to the program. This is Mr. New Vegas, and I hope I'm not coming on too strong. We've got some news for you coming right up. A package courier found shot in the head near Good Springs has reportedly regained consciousness and made a full recovery. Now that's a delivery service we can count on. Also in the headlines, merchants are saying that there's been little contact between traders from Nipton in recent days, causing concerns that the isolated town may be in trouble. And that's the news. Here's Bing Crosby reminding us of those times when you absolutely have to kiss the person you love. Something's gotta give. Up next.
When an irresistible force such as you meets an old...
Well, we've got a new rifle, which, as long as we take care of it, will be our main workforce. This is the standard service rifle of the entire NCR Army. And one that Sam is very excited to get his hands on. In fact, he's probably going to do the bad thing and pump a few of the weapon repair kits into it just to make sure it lasts before continuing on the road. Now, dealing with these ghouls down here kind of turns his stomach just a little bit. So he's probably going to take turn back toward the highway so that he can keep away. Ghouls unnerve Sam. Not really the everyday ghoul, like traveler, settler, but feral ghouls. He doesn't like how just animalistic they that human-like things can become. So he's probably got an issue with tribals, too, if he was being honest with himself. What is this? Look at that. Much better. With Eddie helping us out with these recon sensors, we're going to be able to definitely keep getting the drop on these guys. Yeah. Not so nice. But this is holster your weapon at Gamora. Don't go off half-cocked. Eddie, I'm getting some mixed messages. Let's just head on inside, yeah? That's actually a book. Bitter drink? Hey, that's nice. Healing powder. Some stim packs. Hey, get him, Eddie. Here we go. Dead prospector. Just move you over a second. There's a bottle cap. An ace of spades. Some rounds. Joker 2, Gamora. Hey. Used to be a slave, huh? Carton of cigarettes. This wouldn't be a terrible place to hold up if it wasn't just noon. I wonder what else constitutes as a small rifle round. 5mm. Is that it? Breakdown rocket. What about your multi-tools? Can I make something? Thank you. Guns and bullets. Guns are increased by 3. That's huge. Armor rifle. Millimeter pistol. Robin skin. Not really. Keep moving. If we can help it. We're getting closer and closer to our goal. It's a rest stop. We could pop into there. Let's see. Rad Scorpions. I'm ready to clear you out. Oh! Nice. A laser rifle. Look at that. I'll be taking that. Eddie, why don't you hold on to that for me? And That too. Perfect. Thanks, bud. Okay. Pugilism. Illustrated. Get a little bit good with my fists. Better. Yeah. Look at that. Then we've got a bottle cap, yep, vodka, why not, and Mayor Stein's journal. Guess whose luck keeps rolling? I can hardly believe my luck. Literally, I'm agape. Just now, I was approached by a rather intense young man calling himself Mr. Fox. Yeah, right. When we were alone in my office, he let it be known that he is a member of Caesar's Legion. He knew that NCR troops and powder gangers often spend time in Nipton. It turns out that the Legion hates and wishes to make an example of both groups. The NCR for obvious reasons, and powder gangers for harassing Legion raiding parties on this side of the river. I didn't have to think a moment about Mr. Fox's proposition before accepting it. All I have to do is convince the powder gangers to kidnap the NCR troops at night. When both groups are in town, the Legion boys will scoop everyone up. Ha! For this simple task, I have been offered 8,000 caps. I can almost go back to the NCR right away, but who knows how much else I might make off this Legion lackey. I'm going to start stockpiling some supplies in a safe house between here and the Mojave outpost just in case I decide to head back home in a hurry. Very exciting. Signed with a steady hand on the keyboard, Super Mayor Joseph B. Stein III, Esquire. Something tells me Eddie Nipton may need our help. But we're right here by the outpost. We could see if there's any support we can gather. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. So, as Sam and Eddie continue to climb the hill toward the Mojave outpost, this is where we're going to end today's episode. If you're enjoying the playthrough and you like to watch live, consider giving me a follow here on twitch.tv/JeffTheNarrator469 so that you know every time that I come online. I've seen that animation. Never mind. Or if you prefer to watch on YouTube, you can always find me there as Jeff the Narrator. Things do not seem good for Nipton. If the Legion has been dealing with the mayor, any troops in that area could be compromised. And not only was he greedy, he's stupid too. So, in the next one, we'll head up the hill and see if we can get relief. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, keep telling stories.